Peace guys, and welcome to a new video, my dear butterflies. Today I have a special degree from Princess Ilse with me. Let's see what is written on here. Oh yes, she decreed that all of you look freaking amazing and you shouldn't let anyone tell you otherwise. That's what's standing right here. So yeah, it's now officially a decree. You have to follow it, and yeah. That's that. So do not let anyone tell you otherwise, okay? Good. And now that that's out of the way, we're watching another fan edit. This one is from Ghost Whisperer. It is called Jim and Melinda Silhouette by I Love Hurtius. And it got 19,593 views. So let's get straight into it, shall we? Okay, I am gonna leave a like. You can do that as well. And let's get straight into this reaction. Let's go.
The fact is that what is gone is gone. I'm not Jim. I'm not your husband.
Wait, you're not? Oh, right, that is the last season, right? I think Jim died and then some other ghost went into his body or something? But wasn't there also the thing that Jim tried to come back alive and went into another body? I'm so confused right now. I haven't seen this in too long. Damn. please write in the comments if you still remember that. However, what I actually wanted to say was that's Jennifer Love Hewitt was also in Criminal Minds, by the way. And I loved her in it. I absolutely loved her in it. She was great for like one season. She was there like one season, but she was absolutely great in it. As Kate.
You can be hard to resist.
Yeah, they were so freaking cute. Like the two of them are so cute. And then I had to kill him.
Am I dead?
No.
Look at me right here.
You never know with you.
I want you to remember me this way.
Right now is all that counts.
We just can't be together right now, that's all. It's our fork in the road until we meet again.
Just so cute. Also, I absolutely loved it that he had no real proof that she can actually see ghosts, but he believed her nonetheless. I just love that, like, he actually, like, helped with, like, getting ghosts to the other side, even though to him she was, like, talking with air, you know? Also, the whole ghost, talking to ghost thing is very, very creepy. Like, honestly, I could not be doing that. Like, just waking up and then, like, there's, like, a ghost standing in front of me or just walking to the city. And, like, I can see people that, like, are not there for other people. That is just way too creepy. I'm sorry. Nope. And there are so many creepy moments in this show where like a ghost gets way too intrusive. Just like there's this one thing where there's like a storm and she feels like there's like someone in the house and she walks around and they're just like out of nothing. One second there's nothing and the next second there's like a ghost like this close to her face. I was like, what the fucking hell? No, thank you very much. Yeah. Also, I think they explain it the way that, like, kids can see ghosts, and she just kept that thing inside her that, like, alive, you know? That normally only kids can see ghosts, and adults lose that, but she just didn't lose it because she kept that kid in her alive. So somehow, I think they explain it in some way like this, or at least at the beginning. Maybe there's a better explanation later on that I do not remember, but that was the beginning explanation, kind of. Strangers in your head. Yeah, right. He went into another body.
Wait a minute, could you do that again? Could you just laugh? Because that sounded familiar. Let's go out in flames
so everyone knows. Or was she in another?
You should just get your things and leave.
Linda.
Goodbye.
Okay, so he got back into his, like, I don't actually 100% remember. I think Jim went into another body, and it just didn't really remember her, or he went back in his own body and then he didn't remember her anymore. There was, at the last season, there was someone and somebody. Some ghost went into a body, and something was with Jim because Jim died or something, and some ghost went into somebody. I think they didn't remember Melinda, or they went in another body, or something with a ghost in a body, honestly. I can't tell if Jim went back into his own body and just, you know, lost his memories, or if he went into a new body, into the body of another person, and I honestly cannot remember. If another ghost went into Jim's body, I have to watch the show again. Every time I watch one of those fan edits, I'm like, okay, I have to watch that again. Okay, I have to watch it again. Okay, I have to watch that show again. Like, every freaking time. I cannot just keep re-watching shows because there are so many new shows that I also want to watch. It is so hard. There's not enough time on this earth for me to watch and re-watch all of those shows. The same with books. It's tragic. It is a real tragedy, guys. Honestly, that's why I always say, if like I get the opportunity to become like a vampire, I will take it. And preferably like the vampire from like Vampire Diaries, who can like manipulate people with their eyes. So then I just can, you know, kind of like get into like big mansions and stuff like Catherine Pierce, and get money that way, you know, by manipulating. Yes, I would be stealing money from people. But only from the rich, guys. Only from the rich. So I wouldn't try to get in anyone's way or something. Like, I was just like, take what I need to survive, you know, and to live a like not necessarily normal, but a good life. Not too rich, not too poor, you know, something like that. And then I would just spend my entire time watching TV shows and reading books. Because I think they also don't need... Wait, the vampires from Vampire Diaries need to sleep, I think. But other vampires don't, so... Maybe I just want the not needing to sleep and the manipulation power from Vampire Diaries combined. That would be great. That would be absolutely great.
I mean, you and I are bound together.
Not now.
Oh, they are so cute. And they are so sad as well, but they are so freaking cute.
And they're soulmates.
Yeah, I think they're also a really healthy couple, honestly.
You know how they're supposed to be. Like us. Please believe me. For the gym that I love.
I see ghosts.
He is something Sam never will.
How did you know?
But if it's supposed to be funny, it's not.
I love you. I love you.
They're also like a really healthy couple, if I have it right in my mind, because most of the time, like, if you have like relationships on TV and there's like not many other relationships that you can like create drama around, and like there's only so much drama that you can like create around the relationship, they often use like drama inside the relationship and like make that relationship kind of toxic. And I feel like they are not. Like, I feel like they are already healthy. If you're like a psychologist and you completely disagree, please write in the comments and enlighten me. But as far as I can tell, I feel like they are a really healthy couple. They have a lot of tragedy happen to them. They have a lot of tragedy going on around them. But they themselves in their relationship are really healthy, I feel like. Yeah.
You tried. I will never forget that.
I do know one thing. No matter what's ahead for us, I'm ready to go down any road with you. Go through any door. To know that now, more than I ever did.
Just call me Jim.
What?
call me Jim, no? It's my name.
Jim.
Ah.
Okay, so it ends with Jim either remembering or Jim... Yeah, I think he's in another body, right? I think he went into another body and we just see him in this body most of the time because she can see ghosts or because it's him inside that body, so we see who the soul is, you know, we see the soul, not the body. I don't remember, but I think Jim went into, you know, another body, then he had amnesia for a while, and I think she knew that he was in that other body, because she saw him go in there or something, and then he had amnesia for a while and didn't remember who he was before that, and then at some point he remembered. So she had Jim back, just in another body. Something like that, I think.
Oh,
they're so cute together. So they are absolutely amazing together. I love Jim and Melinda. They are definitely somewhere on top of my favorite couples. Also, they are probably one of the only healthy couples that are on that shortlist. Because there's so many unhealthy to be couples. Like, oh my god, there are so freaking many unhealthy to be couples. That was that. I hope you liked the video, and then I hope I will see you in my... next video again. Until then, bye guys.